somebody on the beach was reading one of my books, and a guy came over to him and said, "Are you reading a book by Dershowitz?" And he said, "Yes," and he punched him in the mouth. I got that letter today. I'm going to be posting it on Twitter. Recently, there was an event in Martha's Vineyard of Jewish Democratic leaders. Who is the most Jewish, well-known Democrat on Martha's Vineyard? Me. I didn't get invited. Old friends have refused to invite me to concerts and events because they say if you're invited, no one will show up. And this includes some very prominent politicians, some very prominent people who are part of this cancel culture. And they canceled me because I defended the constitutional right of President Trump.
Yeah. So Dershowitz has got the whole cancel culture thing mixed up. The idea that like you'd lose a job, that's the thing they normally say. That's the cancel culture. No, the idea that if you're at a party, nobody wants to come, that's not cancel culture. That's you sucking. And I get that like everybody's entitled to their own kink, but it's a specific one to go on TV to talk about how nobody wants to party with you. Dershowitz, what has become of you? But he said he would post that letter.
R.I.P. Epstein. Oh my God, the only one who would want to party with you, Jeffrey Epstein. Yeah, on pedo island.
Enough parties. Yeah, enough parties. Not you, him. Not you. You haven't been there. But anyway, he said he was going to post that letter, and he did. And I love this letter. I'm going to read just an excerpt. I was reading your book yesterday at the beach when some guys who I was playing beach volleyball with asked me about the book that I was reading. And so I showed them the book. They then asked why I chose this book. And so I told them that I had a great deal of respect for the author. The next thing that happened came as a total shock to me. Without warning, I was slugged and punched in the face. I asked why that was called for. And I was told that it's because his political viewpoint and mine differ. I told them that I get it, that our viewpoints differ. But why can't we at least be civil about it? With that, he laughed, shoved me once into the sand and kicked sand all over.
Like a cat, just like covering up his poo.
What is this? Is this SpongeBob? What is going on here? Like, if that actually happened, that's terrible. But I feel confident laughing at it because there ain't no way that happened. First of all, that you'd write about the incident like that, if that's what happened to you. But that like a person who's been playing beach volleyball with you, this is a person you've been socializing with, is like, Dershowitz, kaplow. And then you'd be on the ground. But sir, why? Why have you struck me so? Because our viewpoints differ. That's not how fights work.
Our viewpoints differ is the best. Like that's like, what? You say that after punching someone in the face?
No.
First of all, volleyball people at the beach are the happiest people at the beach. Yes. Number one, I want to say, I don't know what's going on with them, but they are just like, they're living in a Malibu Barbie dream house. Okay. That's like nothing but beach volleyball and visors and like, you know, Ryan Gosling and whatevs, Margot Robbie and Coronas. Life is great. They don't have time for you. Like, do you read, nerd? Just like the volleyball people are like, they're the bullies on the beach. That being said, it is something that I feel like I would do. It's like see someone reading Dershowitz and be like, really? Are you really reading Dersh? I mean, I wouldn't hit them, but I would want to.
Mm-hmm. I'd maybe kick the sand. I wouldn't hit them.
Maybe
no.
Kick the sand.
For who is at the beach like? Playing a little bit of volleyball and then, oh no, I'm just gonna be over there chilling with my Dersh. I don't believe any part of this story actually happened. I don't believe it. I do think that he doesn't get invited to parties. I can buy that. I don't have a lot of sympathy for him. You've defended horrible people. You've sullied your reputation. You're tied to Trump. Like that, people have no requirement legally to spend their social time with you. Nobody is owed that.
And especially when you keep on explaining how you have a perfect sex life every time we bring up Epstein and the fact that maybe you got sexual favors from one of his underage, you know, slaves effectively. Yeah. And you're like, I have a perfect sex life. Like, you know, nobody needs that over hors d'oeuvres, you know?
Nobody needs that.
Nobody wants that.
No. But anyway, he's been complaining about not being invited to parties on Martha's Vineyard since literally at least 2018. We'll put up a graphic. He wrote a column. This guy has been party cucking himself for going on half a decade because he's not invited to parties on Martha's Vineyard. Dude, I don't get invited to parties on Martha's Vineyard. I don't post on Tumblr about it. What is going on? Go hang out with conservatives. That's your crew now, man. And maybe they won't punch you in the face.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.